Hi, in this video, I'm going to show you how I do reverse engineer this motorcycle sprocket with the highest precision. I have already made a 3D scan of this sprocket in my previous video using Creality Sermoon X1. In mechanical engineer, we classify precision level into 20 classes. Most modern engine parts are machined to IT7 class tolerance, which is about plus or minus 40 microns for 180 millimeters long part. And from my testing, Creality Sermoon X1 can be used to inspect the part that is machined with the IT5 tolerance, which is about plus or minus 18 microns for 180 millimeters long part. And if you have the Creality Sermoon S1 or the Raptors, you can use it for inspection the part with the IT7 precision level or below. And for the Creality Scan Otter, I recommend that you use it for part with the precision level of IT9 or below. This is a real project that I'm doing for one of my customers. The part has been severely worn out, so I'm going to show you some technique that I use to recover the worn out dimension. The scan data from the X1 may look similar to the scan from the Raptor and the S1 when you put it side by side, but when you slice the point cloud into the thin section when doing the reverse engineering, the scan from the X1 is very different from the scan from the Raptor or the S1. The X1 has higher precision, so it can detect even a slight change in the geometry. And you will see this in the following video. Okay, this is Autodex Inventor. And the first step that you should do before start reversing is by placing your scan data at the exactly center point of the origin. I have already aligned this in Cloud Compare, but it's not in the exact center point. So I will do it again using Autodex Inventor. First, I'm going to make a thin slice of the point cloud. And then I'm going to create a sketch to check the center of this hole, but okay, now you can see that this slice of the hole is not circle. Maybe because when the user remove and install it, they have to tap it and the edge of the hole is damaged. So I'm going to unclip this and choose another location for slicing. Okay, now you can see that this time looks more like a complete circle. I need to move the point cloud up for 16 micron and move it to the right 2 microns. So I'm going to move it to the right for 2 micron, move it up for 16 micron along the y-axis. Okay, next I'm going to create a profile for revolving, and you can notice that on the tip of the sprocket, it has a taper end. This one is also taper, and I don't think it's from the wear of the part because every tooth it has a taper. I think the designer made this by intention, maybe to keep the chain far inside of the machine. I think they do two-step taper. This is the second step of the taper. Okay, now I'm trying to demonstrate the performance of the X1 scanner. It's made for this kind of job for reverse engineering. You won't see this kind of detail with the S1 or the Raptor. You need to use the a professional grade 3D scanner that costs $20,000 to review this detail. Okay, next I'm going to use the revolve command. Click on axis. This should be the profiles for the sprocket. I think the profiles should be a little bit longer. Let me do some adjustment. And if you check the taper angle of this hole, it's 84.06 degrees. So I think it's 84 when they set it up in the production drawing. But as I said before, a part like this, it has tolerance. So 0.06 angle is actually the machining tolerance. So they produce this part with a very high precision machine during that time. I think this is horizontal. And for the sidewall, it's a little bit of the taper. Yeah, it's about 5 degrees taper. So it's going to be the same on this side. I'm going to make a horizontal line. Okay, next I'm going to make a cutout for the sprocket tooth. There are 18 of them. Let me draw this line with tangent to this line. Okay, let's see, I lock this. I'm going to lock this one and tangent it. So I was wrong. This is the side where it's wear off. This is the perfect side. So I need to draw this again on this side. Okay, this will be the worn out part of the sprocket, not this side. So it's worn out on the right side of the sprocket. So the sprocket has 18 tooth. So one tooth is 20 degrees apart. This angle will be 10. It has to be 10 degrees. And I'm going to miller this. I have a new problem. The tooth here is not worn out. The tooth on this side is worn out. So I need to miller this profile to this profile. Okay, let's do it again. Okay, then I'm going to miller this back. So this is distribute the original profiles of the sprocket. So each side is worn differently. So I need to follow it precisely. Okay, let me cut this out. Cut it through. Okay, this will be the tooth cutting with the original profiles. Next, I'm going to do a circular alley for the extrusion and for the rotation axis. Z axis, there will be 18. 18 tooth, click on OK. Now it's done. So I have already told you in many of my videos that you cannot use automatic surfacing tool for doing a reverse engineering. It's going to follow every defects from your 3D scan. Your part will not fit. Highly recommend that you only use CAD software for reversing your part. There is no alternative way. From this example, if you use the automatic surface to patch surface, it's going to make a lot of mistake like this. It will follow your scan data and you will eventually cannot use it for production. Okay, this is a drawing environment in the Audax Inventor. Let's try perspective. Click on here. One piece. SMC 420 for the materials. C2. Tangent edge. I'm going to go for the color. It's 121. Next, I'm going to cut a cross section. Okay. With a 2:1 scale on the key area. And I'm going to dimension this point. So they have to run the end mill into the tooth, 3.5 millimeter. The angle of the tooth aligned. I just go to the center of the holes. The key is offset 0.3, 11 millimeters, 5 degrees. This one be 4.5. So I need detail section here. 2:1. Okay, so this will be the angle. I don't think I need this section. I'll just remove it. Cross section 2:1 distance. Give a dimension. Give a chain dimension 5.6. Can use this to speeder. So I'm going to specify precision level IT7 unless specified. Okay, this hole will be push fit, right? Push fit with the H7 tolerance, and the shaft will be JS6. So H7 20 millimeters. So it can be 21 microns larger, but it cannot be smaller. Plus 21 micron, plus 21 micron. And for the key is 4.5, 15 micron, plus 16 micron. And for the rest of the tolerance, the operator has to look up from the engineering manual, the IT table, which is this one, ISO 286. Okay, next I'm going to specify the surface finishing. I use 0.8 micron for the most surface, the milling face. And for the rest of the part, I will use 3.2. Okay, so this will be the production order drawings, complete one. And this is the real project that I do for my customer. It's a little bit of complicated for some of you. Okay, thanks you guys for watching. See you in the next video.